Horse Tales is proudly brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. South Carolina, a true leader in the equine industry.
Folks, welcome to an extra special show. Wylie, all our shows are special, but this is extra special. What have you all gussied up? Everything's barred but your underwear, so tell the folks what's going on.
I didn't think you'd recognize me in all this proper attire, David. We are here today at Tally Ho Equestrian Center in Timmonsville. They're having their fall show. It's part of the Camden Equine Circuit. And it's an open show, which is how they allowed, you know, roughnecks like me into it. But I have two of my Marsh Tackies here. I want to show folks they can do more than just hog hunt, and they're not just swamp ponies. So I've got Sweet Home Alabama, and he's going to go over some jumps. This is an English class. This is an English show, so everyone's either doing equitation, flat work, which is walk, trot, canter, or they're going to be going over jumps, and that's your hunter classes. And Bama and I are doing the hunter classes because ever since I got back into horses, I've always loved jumping. And my sister showed growing up. I never did, so I feel like this is my second chance. And I love jumping. So 3 years ago, I started messing around with Bama. I was building jumps out of feed buckets and tree limbs. And so I just started schooling him over little jumps. And so we've kind of progressed along. And I guess today's our real test to see how he does in a real show ring. With other horses around, going over some pretty good sized jumps. I think they're 2 feet, 3 inches, and that's pretty good. But Breeze, I brought Breeze, she's just gonna do a flat class. She's okay. Just gonna do walk, trot, canter. I haven't really schooled her on jumps, but she's actually got a special treat because she's gonna stay here this week, and she's gonna be schooled with Katrina Hutto and her students, and she's gonna be used in a show next week. So, we've got a lot going on today, David. Did I cover it all?
You actually did. So, folks, as I sat here, I was picking at her, who was more nervous, her or me, because, you know, horses have been a journey for me personally. You know, I grew up a little fella, loved horses, and Wylie's story is about the same way. This morning, I was doing a little homework, and Farley and the Black Stallion come across this computer screen, and I thought about you and thought about me at the hardware store when Mama would go to the laundromat. So dreams come true, don't they?
They do. And that's where, you know, I feel like I'm getting a second chance because I grew up with horses, just did a lot of trail riding, just, you know, I saddle without saddle half the time. But now's my chance to get in the show ring. So wish me luck.
So, you know, the old cowboy does do things beside English. I was reading up on English today and us Western folks and us English folks. But horse tails, all breeds, all disciplines, best breed of horse in the world is what you love and what you ride. Wylie, I'm going to give you a charge.
Okay.
I will not change my horse with any threads but on four pastures. When I bestride him, I soar. I'm a hawk. He trots the air. The earth sings when he touches it. Shakespeare. So what? But in the words of Pee Dee Cowboy, you get out there and get her done.
I will, David.
All my life, I've been obsessed with horses. I was curious and wanted to see other people's love for their horses and their stories. I'm David Grant, the Pee Dee Cowboy, and along with some incredible horse owners, I want to share the story of horses and the people that have a passion for them. Horse Tales is being brought to you today by King Street Auction Company, the leading auction company in the Southeast. And by Mark Hossman, the Mark Hossman Training Center. By the South Carolina Agriculture Department, it's a matter of taste. And by Warren Coker's Hayshed, simply the best place to sell your pecans. South Carolina, smiling faces, beautiful places. Folks, come join the Pee Dee Cowboy here at the H. Cooperback Recreation Area for our first annual Pee Dee Horse Festival. Check us out at PeeDeeHorseFestival.com. Hey folks, the Pee Dee Cowboy rides with a brand. My brand of chicken is Carolina Fresh Foods. Carolina Fresh Foods, chicken the way it used to be. Ask for it at your local grocery store. If they don't have Carolina Fresh chicken, call the Pee Dee Cowboy and his Elite Posse Chicken Wranglers and we'll get cracking. And shoot on down to the ranch and round you some up. Carolina Fresh Chicken, simply the most fresh, delicious chicken you can buy.
Farmers are always planning for higher yields, more diversity, expanding opportunities. Nationwide and your local agent want to help your farm last through the generations. As the number one farm insurer in the country, Nationwide can help you achieve your goals. We stand for you.
Are you ready for a new ride? Anderson Brothers Bank has the right payment you've been looking for. If you enjoy a bank that gets to know you and your needs, then Anderson Brothers Bank needs to be your bank. Now is the time to stop by one of our 20 locations throughout the PD and coastal regions, where decisions are made locally. Right car, right payment, right now at Anderson Brothers Bank.
There's a certain pride in knowing our food comes from a place we love, home. And when you consider all our state has to offer, you don't have to go too far to find great tasting food. So the next time you gather around a table, choose certified South Carolina grown. Because here at home, it's a matter of taste.
With me now is Katrina Hutto. She runs the Tally Ho Equestrian Center, and she's put on this great show today. Katrina, tell us what's going on, because we got some horses in here, but we have some horses back there. What is this show all about?
This is a schooling hunter horse show, and it's affiliated with the Camden Equine Circuit. Mm-hmm. And so we have two different rings going on, two different judges, and two different levels of kids. So the ring in the back has our younger kids doing walk. Well, we have some adults too, but mostly walk, trot, canter, and then the little jumps, the cross rails. This is our bigger ring, and so like the ring you competed in is more adults, trainers, older kids who are doing the bigger jumps, and so there's different levels and different age groups in both rings.
Now, will they accumulate points today?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And that goes towards what?
They have a year-end awards banquet. Mm-hmm. So each horse show they go to, they get more points, and it's added up and it's kept up on a website so they can check on it. And then we have a banquet at the end of the year where everybody comes together as a great big family. They all know each other from horse show and everybody's friends, and we have a big banquet together and they give out year-end prizes and awards.
Now, do you have to stay on the same horse through all your shows, or does that matter?
Well, it depends. So if it's equitation, then it's judging the rider, and so they can ride any horse. If it's hunter, it's judging the horse, so the points follow the horse.
I got you.
Now, with the little kid ring, we let all the points go to the little kids, and that way, if they're on lesson horses, it doesn't matter which lesson horse they're on. And that's what this circuit is for. It's for people who, especially the little kids, that ring's much busier than this one because it's the one with all the little kids, and they're riding lesson ponies. So it's a lot of lesson barns that are here today.
Gotcha. Now, I feel like I got a lesson today because, you know, you've been helping me come out, get involved. I came out here last week, and then I came out here yesterday. You got me all the clothes, the proper clothes to wear, and you know, you were showing me techniques. You know, I don't really have any. I've never taken lessons, so you're the closest I've come to having lessons.
Yeah.
So how do you think that Bama and I did with the hunter jumper part?
I thought you guys were awesome. I was super impressed with both tackies, just to see their versatility and their brain and how good they moved, and they jumped well. I was surprised. I was thinking they would be more like used to doing of course this is an outdoor sport, but more like hog hunting or western or trail riding or things like that. But Bama has a beautiful jump on him, and Breeze, both of them were super quiet, level-headed, and they moved really well. So really cute today.
Well, I appreciate it, and I look forward to seeing when you guys use Breeze in this show next week. So she's going to be staying here, and so will you use her in your lessons through the week?
I'd like to, if that's okay with you. I'd like to use her and then let her get used to the program, let her use the different kids riding her and get in the ring. It should give her mileage. And so by next weekend, she'll horse show 2 whole days, so she should have a lot more of horse show experience and miles by next weekend.
Right. That's great to hear, because when I rode her in the flat class, she, you know, I didn't give her any warm-up, and so she was a little distracted, and my fault, she picked up the wrong lead, and I did not know it. So, but it's just been so great. And what ages do you take? I mean, is it all ages?
Yeah, we start our children at 4 years old. So we start little ones, 4 or 5 is best. And they learn quickly at that age, and they come along quickly, and they even have classes for that, the little ones like that. But we take them on. We have adults. You know, we take everybody. We have older adults, younger, everything.
Well, that's great. Well, if someone wanted to get in touch with you and maybe mm-hmm. join your program, how yeah. would they do that?
They could just go to our website. It's mm-hmm. tallyhoequestriancenter.com, and all our information's there, or right. they could just call us directly.
And yeah. you're located right here in Timminsville, mm-hmm. so yeah. and it's really easy to find.
It is.
So thank you, Katrina. Again, I really, really want to say thank you for letting me come out, taking part in the show. You know, I don't really have a background in any of right. this, and I hope I didn't be too much of a roughneck out there.
That was awesome. I thought you did great. I was super impressed.
And I really appreciated the riding tips. Yeah. That's what I loved, is having someone critique my riding yeah. and show me what I could do better. Yeah. So.
Well, you're such a good rider. It just is learning this discipline.
Right. Well, I need to come out here and start taking some lessons from you.
That'd be good.
Well, again, she puts on a great show, folks. You know, you need to come out and check her out at Tally Ho Equestrian Center.
My name is Eliza Madison from Blythewood, South Carolina. Stay tuned for more Horse Tales.
Horse Tales is being brought to you today by...
Warren Coker Hay Farms.
Equestrian Images, making memories together.
By the South Carolina Horsemen's Council, the voice of the horse in South Carolina.
Andrews Mill Hay Farms.
And brought to you by Anderson Brothers Bank. Right car, right payment, right now. Treating you like family since 1933.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
Southern States carefully crafts every bag of Legends horse feed with the highest quality ingredients available. The Legends Superior line of specially formulated feeds will help keep your horses happy, healthy, and in peak form. You and your horse have a special bond. To keep that bond everlasting, Legends Horse Feeds can accommodate every type of nutritional need a horse might have. Legends, redefining what horse feed should be. Visit your local Southern States dealer to see which Legends feed is best for your horse.
Hey folks, the Pee Dee Cowboy rides with a brand. My brand of chicken is Carolina Fresh Foods.
Carolina Fresh Foods, chicken the way it used to be.
Ask for it at your local grocery store. If they don't have Carolina Fresh chicken, call the Pee Dee Cowboy and his Elite Posse Chicken Wranglers and we'll get cracking. And shoot on down to the ranch and round you some up. Carolina Fresh Chicken, simply the most fresh, delicious chicken you can buy.
Are you ready for a new ride? Anderson Brothers Bank has the right payment you've been looking for. If you enjoy a bank that gets to know you and your needs, then Anderson Brothers Bank needs to be your bank. Now is the time to stop by one of our 20 locations throughout the PD and coastal regions, where decisions are made locally. Right car, right payment, right now at Anderson Brothers Bank.
Folks, she got it done, and you wasn't working with Larry the Cable Guy. I was excited and a little nervous for you. I thought you did excellent. I've got tons of questions. Bama and Bree still good. Let's just start off with Bama. Kind of critique your performance.
Yeah, well, again, this is our first show riding English, first hunter show. So what that means is I went over jumps with Bama. We had a little flat class first, and that was just walk, trot, canter. He did really well there. I got a fourth place with that. And then
out of four, right?
Give me a little more credit. So we just kind of got loosened up there, and you know, there's so many things you have to learn to do, because you have to be on the right diagonal when he trots,
mm-hmm.
and that means you're going up in your post with the right leg. And then, you know, when you go into your canter, you have to pick up the right lead depending on which way you're going around the around the ring. So, you know, all those things account. You have to look happy. Your horse has to travel with enthusiasm, like a good working trot, a good, nice, soft canter. Mm-hmm. I think Bama did really well there. Now then we moved into the hunter class. That's when we started going over the fences. And he did really well in the first two. But I think he started getting tired when we got to the third and the fourth class. And that's when you saw him refusing.
Yeah, he refused one jump, one particular jump. I don't know what it was. One particular jump, he refused it. And
he kept refusing that one fence. And so I don't, you never know what it is that makes a horse, you know, want to go over one but not another. But the thing is you get only three refusals and then you're ejected.
Three strikes and you're out.
And
you were out of there.
I was out. We got out and we got ejected in one class. But like I said, that was the third class, and then the fourth class he did better. But we were getting tired. We were out here at 6:45 and practicing, because like I said, he's never done anything like this, and it was fun. But I think he got a really good experience out of it, and I love it out here with Katrina and her crowd, and I hope to do it again.
So. Well, he got rejected, but you didn't get dejected, did you?
No, I didn't.
Now, I was sitting there, and I learned a lot talking to Katrina about different terms and stuff like that from the English perspective of the equestrian world. Now, Breeze, she was doing real well. Now, she's going to be in a class coming up because some of the students are going to use her, right?
Right, right. I rode her in a flat class today, and she didn't do all that well just as far as she was distracted. I didn't have a chance to warm her up this morning because I spent so much time with Bama on the jumps. So she was more concerned about where Bama was. But the thing that got us in that class is she picked up the wrong lead. And I did not realize it until she'd taken so many steps. And if she'd picked it up and then it got, and I realized it and broke it down and got her in the other lead, the correct lead, then it would have been fine. But I realized, oh gosh, I've been on the wrong lead for quite some time. So that gave us, I knew right then we probably weren't going to get a ribbon.
Well, I got a question. You brought Bama and Breeze out here last week. And keep in mind that I'm learning enough to be dangerous, but ask some good questions. Now, they chose to keep Breeze, and they're going to use her and not Bama. Why?
Because she had the her students ride both of them, and Bama was not picking up his right lead at the canter very fluidly. The little girl was really working hard, could not get him to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So they needed a horse that would pick up their leads more readily, more easily at this level. You know, I can make him pick up his right lead, but I know my horse pretty well. So, so Breeze is staying here, and she's going to be schooling with right here at Tally Ho all week long, and then she's going to be used in the show next week.
Well, you folks, you've heard us say all breeds, all discipline with horsetails, and the best breed of horse in the world is what you care for, and the best discipline is what you use. But we're excited. Our little common tackies, we're getting enough of them, and they're getting schooled enough that they're going to be outside of their boundaries.
That's
so
right.
We're really excited about that. So we'll see Breeze in a few weeks in a what type class?
Well, it's going to be middle and high school students riding her, so I won't be riding her. I won't. I'm too old. She may be going over some little jumps. I'm not sure. Katrina hasn't told me, but she'll definitely be doing flat work, which is, you know, the walk, trot, canter.
Well, Wylie, it's kind of like a proud papa watching you.
I'm so glad that y'all came out here, David. I mean, you guys, I love Horsetail supporting me in all my endeavors.
There you go, folks.
With me now is Leslie Lassiter and her daughter Erin Lassiter. Erin's out here competing today. And, you know, there's a lot that goes into these shows. I mean, getting your horse prepped, you have to prep. I mean, Mom, I know you did a lot too. How long have you been taking riding lessons out here?
Since I was six, so that's about 10 years.
And so the whole time, you know, you've been bringing her to these shows. And what's your role as, you know, supporter on the sidelines?
Well, being a cheerleader, for one. And, you know, when we come to the barn, it's always on barn time. Mm-hmm. When we first got here, everybody said, you're on barn time now. And so it's being supportive, helping out, wiping boots, bringing food, water, and
holding the horse.
Yeah.
All those things.
Now,
yeah.
Do you have horse background? Did you grow up with horses?
For a little bit, yes. Yeah.
So, now what made you want to get into horseback riding and especially into the English discipline?
My mom found a ad online saying that there was lessons out here. She said, "Aaron, you want to do this?" And it was a summer camp. And I was like, "Yeah, sure." And then that's how it started.
And how many classes have you competed in today?
I've competed in two.
Okay, and do you have a horse out here, or?
I do, his name is Lance.
But you told me earlier you weren't riding your horse, so.
No, he is currently injured due to a foot injury.
So what's it like hopping on a different horse that you're not used to riding and competing with him?
I mean, it's fine. It's really fun. It's a new experience, and just getting, be able to know the horse and know what works and what doesn't is.
But don't you, Katrina has you guys swap horses a lot just so you do get that, mm-hmm. that, it makes you a better rider because you mm-hmm. don't get just used to one horse. So, are you competing in any more classes today?
Yes, one more, the Tally Ho medal.
Okay, what is that specifically? Is that over fences also? Is that Hunter?
It's just over fences and it's equitation based on the rider. And about 10 people usually compete in it.
Okay, well great. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
I've already watched you. You've done well, so I know you're going to do well again. And thank you all so much for being out here and supporting all this because it's a great time.
Well, thanks for coming out here. We appreciate it.
All right.
Hi, my name is Sarah Cork and I'm from Columbia, South Carolina. Please stay tuned for more Horse Tales.
Horse Tales is being brought to you today by Morrell Tire Service. Ride on in and see Richard and his fine family of technicians to take care of your automotive needs.
Buy pieces for you and your home. By Brock Griffith Horsemanship. And by Nick Myers at Myers Professional Landscaping.
Southern States carefully crafts every bag of Legends horse feed with the highest quality ingredients available. The Legends Superior line of specially formulated feeds will help keep your horses happy, healthy, and in peak form. You and your horse have a special bond. To keep that bond everlasting, Legends horse feeds can accommodate every type of nutritional need a horse might have. Legends, redefining what horse feed should be. Visit your local Southern States dealer to see which Legends feed is best for your horse.
Are you ready for a new ride? Anderson Brothers Bank has the right payment you've been looking for. If you enjoy a bank that gets to know you and your needs, then Anderson Brothers Bank needs to be your bank. Now is the time to stop by one of our 20 locations throughout the PD and coastal regions, where decisions are made locally. Right car, right payment, right now at Anderson Brothers Bank.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
There's a certain pride in knowing our food comes from a place we love, home. And when you consider all our state has to offer, you don't have to go too far to find great tasting food. So the next time you gather around a table, choose certified South Carolina grown, because here at home, it's a matter of taste.
Folks, join me now, Teresa Blackman. She's been with Katrina for a good many years now. Your third barn, is that right?
Third barn, that's right.
And y'all been out here how long?
Almost 15 years, 14, 15 years.
And so what's your background? You said third barn with Katrina, so what's your background with horses?
I started riding when I was 8.
Okay.
And just kept going. Started teaching when I was 18 and hadn't stopped. I'm not going to tell you how old I am, but it's been many years.
Well, that's nice.
Many years.
It's not polite. Well, we've had a great time out here today. Now,
you were out here in another area with, so explain what was going on out there. I'm new to all this now.
That ring out there where I'm at is the Wachot Canter ring. Mm-hmm. And we do the cross rails out there also. Mm-hmm. And it's more like a beginner ring.
Okay.
For the little kids. That's basically it. There's Wachot Canter, and then the cross rails, which is like 18 inches.
Right. So the first class I watched this morning just had three students in, and they were kind of beginners.
Right. And that was the no diagonal class.
Okay.
And that, do you want me to explain what
Yes, absolutely.
Cool. Diagonals, when the horses are trotting, their front legs are going like this. And the rider is posting, when that outside leg goes forward, that's when you're supposed to be out of the saddle. When it comes back, that's when you're supposed to be sitting down. So right. It's up, down, up, down.
So what age group was out here this morning?
It always varies. Today was probably 4 to 12-year-olds.
Folks, we had a great time out here at Tally Ho. You know, folks, the old Pee Dee Cowboy usually don't like sitting on the sideline, but I have to admit today touched my old heart, and I was really proud. Wylie, you jumped in there and had a lot of confidence. And what you holding in your hand there?
Well, David, I'm holding all the ribbons that I won today. These two are from the jump classes, the hunter classes that Bam and I did. We got second place. And he also got a fourth place in a flat class, and that's Breeze's ribbon for her one flat class. So I am going home with some bling to put in my tack room to actually go with the other bling that I won. You know, we did a show back a couple weeks ago about the horse show in down that the Carolina Marsh Tackie Association
right.
had done. And when we wrapped the show up, at that point I hadn't won any ribbons. But and you know, our camera guy had been giving me a lot of grief saying I didn't win any ribbons. But I did, David. I took home quite a few blue ribbons that day. But not today. Just had to got some reds and, you know, a couple. Anyway, we had a good time.
Well, folks, you can take a good ribbon, can't you?
I sure can.
So I'll rub it in pretty good. You know, Wylie and folks, I learned a lot today about English. Like I say, I've kind of been a little narrow-minded, and we work hard here at Horsetails to bring you anything with horses. Mm-hmm. It don't matter what breed, what discipline, anything. You never know where we're going to show up. So, you know, I kind of enjoyed this today. And like I say, in 2 short years ago, I had a granddaughter born, so who knows? And 2 more years, she'll all be right out here. Because just the other day, folks, horses have, like I said, in the past few years, because of the horse, my life has stayed on course. And just the other morning, I went back and some writings that I had, and I had wrote, not really a poem, but a statement about Marsh Tackies and stuff like that, and where I am. And I said, wow, come this far in 5 years?
Mm-hmm.
And Wylie just, and Lord knows how long have we known each other?
I know, gosh. It seems like forever, David.
And folks, today, when we met, we kind of worked some horse deals. And watching Breeze today perform, which is one of the first fillies off my stallion, right?
That's right. And one of the first that I ever trained. And so, you know, it's been a walk with her and bring her here and do this. And same with Bama. He was one of my first, too, to train. So, and it's just so great, you know, David. We do this show, but we're not just going places and being talking heads. We're jumping in the game. We're taking part. And, folks, you guys can do that, too. I mean, if the Pee Dee Cowboy and Wylie Bell can do it, y'all can do it, too.
And, folks, until next week, keep your reins low and your hands quiet. And, folks, happy are those who dream dreams and willing to pay the price for them to come true.
See you next week.